45Drives isn't sponsoring this video. I'm filming this in late April 2025, and as of filming, 45Drives hasn't ever sent me any hardware of any kind, nor have they ever paid me a dime or had me out to their workshop in Canada. They have sent me software, but they sent everyone software. It's on GitHub right now, and it's pretty sweet. In today's episode, I'll share my outsider perspective on 45Drives and talk about how I use their open source modules for Cockpit. Modules you can install on whatever hardware you want. Greetings and welcome to another thrilling episode of Veronica Explains. I'm Veronica, and I'm a big fan of 45Drives, even though they haven't sent me any gear, at least not yet. I worked in server rooms for a number of years as a sysadmin, and I've seen a fair amount of enterprise hardware. A lot of these vendors don't seem to care all that much about open source software, so I really do appreciate the work that 45Drives has put into their offerings for Cockpit. And it's not just Cockpit modules, but they also have some great tutorials out there for all sorts of useful server-related stuff. And from my 50,000-foot view, they seem like a helpful player in the storage and self-hosting space. Of course, they're a hardware company first, and they sell a line of server hardware aimed at the enterprise, as well as SMBs and enthusiasts, which I'm sure by now you've seen on YouTube. And yeah, the product is pricey, and I'm sure that folks are about to be arguing about the price of this stuff in my comments, or complaining that 45Drives sends free gear to some YouTubers. As though companies haven't been doing product placement since the dawn of mass media. The way I see it, 45Drives is simply engaging in advertising, and sending creators free stuff is hardly a new phenomenon. The thing is, creators have an obligation to disclose when they get free stuff, and that's not just me saying that. The FTC says it too. And if influencers aren't following those rules, that's not on 45Drives. It's on us. Anyway, this is not a hardware review. Other folks are obviously talking about 45Drives as hardware, and you don't need to hear about it again from me. I want to talk about their open source software, which I've been using for years. And if their hardware sales fund cool open source tools like these, you're not going to get any complaints from me. So 45Drives didn't invent Cockpit. That's an open source tool sponsored by Red Hat. Of course, you don't need RHEL to be able to use Cockpit. I've used it on Debian for a number of years, and it's fine. If you'd like to see a future video where I show how to configure Cockpit, say Red5 standing by in the comments. Cockpit comes pre-installed on some distros, like Rocky Linux, but it's packaged across the Linux ecosystem and should be pretty easy to get installed. By default, Cockpit does a great job of showing your server's status and making logs discoverable, that sort of thing. It's not TrueNAS, nor is it Proxmox, and it doesn't have to be. TrueNAS is great if all you're doing is storage, and Proxmox is great if all you're doing is virtualization and containers. But sometimes you're wanting your server to be a bit more flexible without the hassle of nesting one of those things inside the other of those things or hosting your VMs over LAN. And for folks who want to use a straight distro to maximize flexibility on a single server and have a useful web interface to manage it all, Cockpit is a fine choice. It's also easily expandable with modules, and 45Drives has created some really great ones, which they host on their GitHub. Exactly how you install modules is going to depend on your system, and I'll include detailed instructions for both Rocky Linux and Debian on my website, vkc.sh. I'm also planning on walking through these steps in a live stream, just for the monthly sustainers of Veronica Explains, who make these videos and blog posts possible. The gist of it is that you download a module and extract it to /user/share/cockpit. Some modules might have their own build steps, though, so as always, check the documentation. The two 45Drives cockpit modules that I've enjoyed are the ZFS module and the file sharing module, both of which I'll link in the video description. At present, 45Drives is hosting two ZFS modules. One's an older fork of another project, but the other is a more active module that they appear to be building from scratch. The older module works fine for me as of filming, and while it's not as powerful as the terminal, it does a pretty good job of making ZFS a bit more discoverable. The file sharing module comes as a DEB or an RPM, and after installing it, you have a dirt simple way to configure Samba shares, including shadow copies for those pesky Windows users. I've used these modules for years on my server stack, and they've been reliable tools for me, a non-45Drives customer. I really appreciate how 45Drives put these modules out for everyone to use, and I think it represents a tangible commitment to our open source space. Now, I can already hear the comments. But Veronica, I thought you said you hated corporate influences in Linux! I'm not Pollyannish when it comes to corporate influence in our space. Corporations have driven Linux development forward, and I don't think our ecosystem would be where it is without those professional developers putting work in. And yes, I've been critical of companies who've taken steps away from transparency, and I will continue to do so. But at the same time, I want to make sure that we shine a light on companies that are doing it the right way. And right now, that's what I see from 45Drives. I think there's a big difference between IBM making Red Hat worse and 45Drives making HomeLab better. Not only with hardware, but with software, tutorials, documentation, forums, all from a small team of everyday folks who actually seem to like this stuff. Now, if for whatever reason this video doesn't age well, I'll be sure to pin a comment and you'll likely see a follow-up on this channel. But I just don't see that happening. Friend of the channel Tom of Lauren Systems did a video about the HL series recently. And yes, he was sent free hardware, which he properly disclosed in the first 30 seconds of the video. He was quick to mention that, yeah, while he was sent goodies from 45Drives, his company has spent a lot on their devices over the years. And I've heard countless stories of admins and MSPs deploying 45Drives hardware for enterprise. Now, if you've worked in this space, you know that MSPs don't often risk their reputation on hardware that doesn't hold up. And to me, that's not nothing. Now, we can debate and should debate about whether they're priced appropriately for a product with the HomeLab label. But at the end of the day, I'm just glad that this hardware company is contributing something back for the rest of us. Now, I personally haven't had the privilege of picking up a 45Drives server, but as somebody who's specced out small business offerings over the years, I think that what they're asking is reasonable for what it is, and it'd be on my radar for an enterprise deployment today. And yeah, the price is steep for the enthusiast crowd. Maybe too steep to be called HomeLab, at least to some folks. I personally might have gone with a small office theme myself, but that's totally a matter of opinion. And I think that more than a few HomeLabbers would justify the expense on a chassis that was not only a joy to work in, but also helped support the broader open source community. If you've ever built a server out of big box components, you know that a lot of these chassis, frankly, suck to work in. 45Drives appears to be taking the time to do things differently, and they're helping the Linux and open source community in the process. Some of us care about that, and it's totally okay if your priorities lie elsewhere. I'm a musician, and I used to work in a guitar shop. Some guitarists buy an inexpensive Squire and rip it apart, then rebuild it into a totally custom rig that's tailored exactly to their needs. Other folks buy an American standard, which is a bit pricier, and play it as is. I'm not going to go on YouTube and tell you that one of these ways is correct and the other isn't. You're a grown-up. That's your call. People are going to joke about how you can't fit exactly 45 drives in every chassis, aren't they?